Join me this time from Washington, D.C. is someone who's definitely not a jag-off. She is Middle East expert and firebrand Pamela Geller. Pamela, welcome to the show.
Great to be here, Rick.
And Pamela joins us from our new studios, which are under construction in Washington, D.C., at a very prime location in our nation's capital. So, Pamela, we are watching around the world the narrative that Israel is somehow the bad guy in this story. We're now watching riots in Paris, riots in London. We're seeing flyers left on cars in Chicago. To me, this is a sign to world leaders of what's to come. If Israel is on the front lines of fighting the fight against radical Islam, before radical Islam, in this case Hamas, comes to the West, comes to London, comes to Paris, New York, Chicago, L.A., world leaders should see this as the shot fired across the bow. These riots in their cities and these flyers left in Chicago. Do you agree or disagree?
I completely agree. It's here. We see that Jews in San Francisco at a very pro-peaceful Israel rally were attacked. Muslims are rioting with impunity across the world, victimizing innocent people. And they are rioting in support of a pro-terrorist, genocidal, bloodthirsty ideology. I had an ad campaign that was largely condemned that said, in any war between the civilized man and the savage, support the civilized man, support Israel, defeat jihad. I think these riots, both the very peaceful Israel demonstrations and the very violent pro-Hamas, show which side is the civilized and which side is the savage. I am deeply concerned about this tsunami of Jew hatred. I believe that Hamas knows very well that it can't and won't win in this latest, these latest hostilities against the Jewish state, but they mean to incite the Ummah. They mean to rise up the global Muslim community in this war against the Jews and inevitably, of course, the infidels. Why don't we see these Muslim riots against the annihilation of, Muslims and Christians in Syria? Why don't we see these Muslim riots against Boko Haram, a devout Muslim group in Nigeria that is slaughtering its Christian population? Why don't we see these Muslim riots against honor killings, against clitoridectomies? Why don't we see these Muslim riots against the global jihad? No, we only see it when the tiny Jewish state defends itself. And one only has to listen to Hamas Al-Aqsa TV that calls for the annihilation of the Jews. One only has to read the very first paragraph of the Hamas charter that calls for the annihilation of the Jewish state, all in the cause of Islam, all in the cause of Allah, because Islamic Jew hatred is in the Quran and it is a religious imperative, and the war against Israel is a religious war. Because, even to the most devout Muslims, the Jewish state, the idea of a Jewish state, is offensive and deeply humiliating.
Pamela Geller, some of the mainstream media refer to you as an extremist. I want to point out to our viewers, I want to go on record as telling you, I think your voice is so important to get out there, especially at a time like this. We're watching what extremism is. We're watching it, as you point out, in San Francisco, Chicago, Paris, and London. And what is sad and troubling is that world leaders don't get it. The media doesn't get it. And that's why it's so important to have someone like you voicing the controversial, I call them controversial, but they're not really controversial, the words that you are. Why do you suppose that this mainstream media internationally cannot see black and white? It is a civilized society against radical Islamic terrorists.
Well, the media is aligned with the jihad force. The idea that I'm an extremist. This is the art of the smear, Rick. What is extreme but a modicum, a measure? Is truth, pursuit of truth in the extreme, a bad thing? Is pursuit of justice, is pursuit of liberty? Again, this is a way of smearing, of delegitimizing the messengers of freedom, a pro-freedom of individual rights by smearing and destroying the person, you make it unable for the message to get out. But the beauty of shows like yours, talk radio, and most importantly, social media, Twitter, Facebook, finally, the common man, the individual man, the lone man has a voice. And we're seeing it impact the coverage, and we're seeing it even impact the enemy media. And they are the enemy. They are the enemy of freedom. They're notoriously and have been anti-Israel. This whole idea of a libel against the Jewish state, the whole idea of an occupation, for example, there is no occupation. In 1922, the League of Nations granted the Jewish state sovereignty over a Jewish homeland with Judea and Samaria. Area, that is international law.
Pamela Gaylor, no one ever talks about, what the media doesn't talk about, what world leaders don't talk about, is the Jewish population which exists in Arab states today. It's practically non-existent, is it not?
There is no Jewish population in the Muslim world. In 48, close to a million Jews were ethnically cleansed from Muslim lands. And we're seeing that today. As Muslim law, Islamic law, also known as the Sharia, takes hold in, for example, Iraq, they have literally ethnically cleansed, annihilated the Christian population there. Just this week, it's astounding that the actual New York Times did a story on the very last Christians leaving Mosul. And the fact that their homes were marked with an N for Nazarene, to mark them for extermination or to exact upon them an exorbitant tax that's mandated by Qur'an 929, the jizya, an exorbitant poll tax imposed on non-Muslims who live a subclass status, the dhimmitude, in Muslim states. We are seeing this across the world. We're seeing this in Africa. When Obama sided with the jihadists in Libya and ousted Gaddafi. No prince, I agree, but there's worse.
Right.
Libya has become a terror state. And Mali fell to Al-Qaeda. Central African Republic is, a mess. But now so is Mali, is now an Al-Qaeda state. And Central African Republic, the Christians are being slaughtered. Nigeria is a bloodbath. The Buddhists in Thailand, these are all under the siege of jihad.
Pamela,
and the media doesn't talk about it.
In the interest of time, I have to jump in and leave it right here. I just want to say that with the constant misinformation being put out by the mainstream media, it is important to have your voice out there opening the eyes and educating the American people on what's happening. We thank you for joining us.